Good morning, Kent Forest.
Good morning.
Always like singing in this church. As I was preparing for this morning, I couldn't help to, As I was preparing for this morning, I couldn't help to think of three words that Paul spoke to the Thessalonians. Actually, I've been preparing for more than just this morning. Three words that Paul spoke to the Thessalonians. And you can go back and look at it and see that it's a little slightly out of context the way I'm going to use it. But he speaks these three words in 1 Thessalonians 5:17. He says, "Pray without ceasing." Okay. What does that look like for you? Pray without ceasing. This sounds like a pretty tall order. Does that mean that we should be on our knees all the time, praying for His kingdom to come and to be fulfilled? Is that what that means? I don't think so, because we don't have an example of that. Even Jesus Himself, we witness what it says about Him in the Bible. We didn't see Him on His knees 24 hours a day. Does it mean that we should be in a spirit of prayer? Possibly that's more in line with what He was trying to communicate to us, and what God was trying to communicate through Him, is to be in a spirit of prayer. What does that look like? Good question, huh? For me, I know that I'm thankful for a time during the day when a person's name comes to mind, and I think to pray for that person. I am thankful for a time when maybe I hear an ambulance go by, and I think somebody is in bad shape. Else they wouldn't be in an ambulance, or the ambulance wouldn't be going to get someone. And I think to pray for them. I'm thankful for that inspiration, and I pray that that is because God is growing me. I'm thankful for that. But what about times when we are in a bad situation? What about times when we're hurting so deeply in our hearts? And when we get on the other side of that, we look back and we think, you know, I should have probably prayed about that and seen what God could have done in that situation at that time, instead of me trying to push through it and do it on my own, because that's not what this is all about, the Christian life. The Christian life is to be in concert with the One who created us. We have appointed times that we pray, and the common ones are, you know, in the morning and when we eat our meals and when we go to bed, and those things are fine, but pray without ceasing. What does that mean? I believe that it means that allowing God, His Holy Spirit, to work through us, that constantly we will be thinking about others. Constantly we will be thinking about our own problems and struggles that we're going through, and we're lifting that up in prayer, then, not waiting till the appointed times, but then. This song speaks to that very thing. Do you wait till the appointed time to pray, or do you pray now? Listen to the words of this song. There are things in every journey that can break us. There are burdens that can bring us to our knees. But it's in those moments when our faith is weakest that we simply stand our ground and just believe. Pray. Right here in the storm, He's still the same.
pray now, there is strength and power in Jesus' name. So pray now. All the silence does it mean that he's not listening? And the darkness does it mean that he is gone? 'Cause he promised he would never ever leave us. And you've never spent one moment on your own. So pray now. Right here in the storm, he's still the same. Right here in the storm, he's still the same.